Clyde and I go fishing a lot. And we were up to Aziscohos, you see, and we were going across to fish on the other side, and we were going right into this terrible wind, you know. We had a hard time, and we were going right into the wind all the way. And Clyde says, I hope this wind's going the other way before we go back. You know, this out-of-state, they calmed down here a little. This out-of-state was driving through Greenwood in the 10-mile rut, as we call it. It was raining real hard, and when he come to a small stream, he found the bridge washed away. Now, Clyde was standing there with a fish pole in his hand. The driver said, how deep is the water? Clyde says, I don't know. Driver says, you think I could drive through it? Clyde says, oh, yeah, no trouble there. So the guy drives in, the car sinks out of sight. Well, he finally swims out, and he yells at Clyde, what's the idea of telling me I could drive through that stream? It's over 10 feet deep. Clyde says, that's funny. He says, it's only up to here on the docks. Yes, sir. You know, most people think if you're going to outsmart a fish, you got to have more brains than the fish. Not so, says my friend Freddy. He says the smaller the fisherman's brain, the better his chances of catching a fish. The reason is that a fisherman tries to think like a fish, whose brain is very small, you see. So the smaller the fisherman's brain, the better his chances, you see. It stands to reason.